In this video, we're going to go over the first fundamental theorem of calculus. Now, reminder, we already had the second fundamental theorem of calculus, which says that if f prime is little f, in other words, if big F is an antiderivative of little f, then you can compute integrals of little f by just evaluating big F at the endpoints. Really powerful result. So all sorts of problems about finding integrals boil down to a problem of finding an antiderivative. But what if there is no antiderivative? That would be a problem. Fortunately, we have the first fundamental theorem of calculus. The first fundamental theorem of calculus says that as long as f is a reasonable function and continuous functions are reasonable, then the integral function, which is the running total, this is sometimes called the indefinite integral, is an antiderivative. So the derivative of the running total is the value of the function. Okay, nice result. So why is it true? So let's take a look at a problem here. So here we have the s, y, and here we have the curve y equals f of s. And we're interested in the running total. So the running total up to x, that's going to be I of x. And we want to figure out what is the derivative of I of x. So by definition, the derivative of I of x, well, that's a limit. It's the limit of I of x plus h minus I of x divided by h. So here's x plus h. And I of x plus h is all the area from a to x plus h. And I of x is all the area from a to x. And what's the difference between them? Well, the difference between them is the red area. It's just the area between x and x plus h. And we want to divide that by h. So if you think of this as being approximately a rectangle, you got the width times the average height, that's the area, and you divide by the width, and you're just going to get the average height. Now, if you have a continuous function, the average height between x and x plus h, it doesn't have a chance to change by very much. The average height is going to be close to f of x. And if you make h really small, then f doesn't change very much in here. And so the average is going to be very, very close to f of x. The smaller you take h, the closer you get to f of x. So as h goes to 0, the average goes to f of x. And we're done. The derivative of the running total is the function itself. Okay, let's check this with an example. So let's take the function f of x equals x. So when we write things in terms of s, we get f of s equals s. And we want to figure out what is I of x. Well, I of x is the area between a and x. So this is I of x. And what is that area? Well, it's the area of this big triangle minus the area of this little triangle. So what's the area of the big triangle? Well, 1/2 base times height. The base is x, the height is x, so the area of the big triangle is x squared. The area of the little triangle, base is a, height is a, 1/2 base times height is a squared over 2. So I of x is x squared over 2 minus a squared over 2. What's the derivative of that? X. So sure enough, in this example, it works.